AJ, whoa.
Mine's electrical enough again, yeah.
So that was the last part. So the part of all has been won.
Yes.
But has the...
AJ, how would you think, what's your perception of the AJ?
I think we're in the infancy. And I think we're following ideas from elsewhere. And we should take those ideas and make context sensitive for Africa. We have different challenges. So I'd like to believe that it won't be a war, but a long transition. So we haven't won anything yet. We're far.
Anyone else? Over there. John Wood.
I'm finding it really hard to hear you.
This thing.
Yeah.
Let me think that even an agile, we always say people is important and part of the process, but I don't think we teach all. We really think about personalities and making people balance. And even the simple thing of you walk into the office, you see someone is unhappy. A lot of in the corporate environment, you actually just go on with your day. I think that personal interaction with people in teams and matching people in teams is not being done. Did you agree?
Okay, so the question is more on that this gelling of people in the workplace that we experience ourselves in right now is not being done enough. And do I agree? And the answer is yes. I think Chris asked you to ask me that. I don't think we can make people do that. You know, I think it's something that we have to be conscious of. We have to have these ongoing conversations about what is true. And it might be, you know, you might get polarization or unity based on a simple thing like who supports the Googles. You know, it's strange. It reminds me of another talk I did where I said, it's funny how we hire. We'll put up these kind of these adverts to say, you know, super good C-sharp dev, X years experience, Arsenal, blah, 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 blah. And right at the end we say, must be a team player. Right? How about we invert that? How about we change around and describe it as, hey, our team likes Googles, we're non-smokers, we enjoy the squash league, we're passionate about this, that, and that. Do you think we can put in? I think that's a better way.
The thing is, you can learn to code, but how do you teach somebody to support the Google? Anyone else? Looks like no. We're going to have another wait. Thank you.
So obviously when you talk about dialogue between the people and the teams and getting things like that, are there any tricks that you use, such as bringing in people like yourself to come in their own teams, or bringing in a legal coach to find converse people and actually not to bad offers?
So, do I have any tricks to actually encourage this kind of sharing of histories and backgrounds and things like that? No, I don't have any tricks. But food works. It works. And the thing is that because it creates a gentle place. And I often try to find out more about the person. You know, I grew up in a society where it was an insult when you met someone not to ask them how are they, how's their mother, how's their father, how's their sister, etc. You know, that is the kind of society that I and childhood that I grew up in. And I think we've lost that. So I might not have tricks, but I think it just comes down to also simple decency. It's that thing of, hey, how are you? If someone is late, is having a miserable time at work, and the performance has dropped, maybe you should care about what's happened in that person's life. Maybe you're a sick child at home that's just really occupying their mind. But if you understand that this person has, you know, two kids and one is really ill, it's all right. You know, so it's a minutiae. in our day-to-day existence that actually brings that out. Just don't fix things. I don't think they are. I'm sorry, you're not. But hey, you can try to do both, but what do you do?
Yeah, you must do
something. But at least now he's worked for the screen, so it's fine.